I've been working on a video descending before the big event taking place in Madison Square Garden that Hakjan is pulling off called Peace Starts With Me! Pah! Excuse me. Now I'm trying to be entertaining, don't take this the wrong way. I'm not anti-how mother, I'm simply pro-father, pro-Christ, pro-Trilla, pro-principle, pro-kingdom, pro-etc. And yes, I really do care about mother, I pray for her to get off her unprincipled ways. I hope you enjoy this video, peace out!
The 2000 year history of the providence of God centering on Christianity, from God's point of view, this 2000 year history has been the providence to find the only begotten daughter.
Wait, hold on. Wait, what? You woke my
demons. Now this poison ring running through my veins.
Hey everyone, Prince Gideon here. I know that there is confusion and tension between sanctuary and family fed. I talk to my friends about it and they don't like the division, and I don't like the division either. But unbeknownst to you, mother is creating a new theology! And she's saying it right into your face! Gah! This is just a little snippet of how she's creating a new parallels of history. Parallels of history. Wait, does anyone know about parallels of history? The DP? Anyone? Okay, raise your hand if you do know. Raise your hand if you don't know! Seriously? There's no hope for humanity! Alright, quick synopsis.
This better be quick!
Parallels of history shows mathematical evidence of God's hand among the chosen people between the Israelites and the Christians who share similar events in order to receive the Messiah. God's providence worked through Abraham and the people of Israel to receive Jesus as the Messiah, to the apostles and the body of Christ to receive the Lord at the second advent. Each of these faced parallel events in mathematical order, starting from their time of slavery and persecution, settling their lands as tribes, established a kingdom, divided their kingdoms, their big screw-up due to polytheism and corruption, and settling back into their lands, developing a deeper understanding of philosophy, religion,
in your face,
and technology to prepare for the coming Savior. Oh, you got that? So the thing is, Mother is saying something different. Yeah, I'm gonna comment along the way to make sense out of her speech.
Jesus gave the message, the word, so that everyone could fully understand. Nonetheless, Christians, how can I say it? They are blind. They have been blind to Jesus' message.
Means that they weren't the chosen people. Don't believe me? Just keep on watching.
That is why, at that time, the only begotten daughter could not be found at the time of Jesus. The foundation to give birth to the only begotten daughter had to be restored by heaven.
Seriously, red flag anyone? She's saying that the only begotten daughter existed during Jesus' time. Someone that was born sinless, and yes, it is evident that she means sinless. Why? Well, you heard it. Apparently, heaven is the one that restores the only begotten daughter's birth in Jesus' time. Yes, birth. Not like how we were taught that Jesus is supposed to raise up a fallen woman to then become the true mother of humanity. Nope! Birth! Which is quite odd because anyone that is born sinless from birth has to have Christ's spirit. There can't be two people with Christ's spirit.
I don't know which one to follow. I'll follow both.
Otherwise, there'd be two lineages, which essentially means two subjects, which essentially means
polytheism!
My girl Lilith knows there's God the Son Christ. You never hear of God the Daughter Christ, right? Okay, let's move on.
And that is why God could no longer work through the Jewish people, through the people of Israel. Looked for a different people.
And fast forward.
They were the chosen people. And through them, the people of Han, they loved white clothes.
I don't care how white they like their clothes.
Because they ain't got no Jesus. Pass me the bleach, Jesus.
See? See? I'm telling you. This whole Han dynasty being the chosen people ain't in no DP. Okay, we went over this before. The chosen people after the Israelites were the Christians, such as Paul, the guy who ignited the fire of Christianity. King Charlemagne wanted to offer a Christian kingdom for the second coming, and Martin Luther,
in your face,
who freed the people to have their own personal relationship with the Bible rather than being dominated by a theocratic system. And I could go on, but she has dismissed all of that and went straight to this Han Dynasty thing. If we think logically from the basis of the DP, the foundation of Christianity is to find the Messiah, right? But if we follow her logic, she's saying the chosen people were of the Han Dynasty, which would simply mean the Lord of the Second Advent is coming from that dynasty's lineage.
Which you can guess. Who is that person?
And that is why the returning Messiah, before the returning Messiah, there must absolutely be a person, and that person is the only begotten daughter. That is, it's me who is standing right here in front of you.
And wait, did you catch what she said earlier? What the heck does she mean the only begotten daughter must come before the returning Messiah?
And that is why the returning Messiah, before the returning Messiah, there must absolutely be a person, and that person is the only begotten daughter.
What? All right, to be fair, maybe it does mention Han Dynasty in the Divine Principle. Let me check it out. Okay, let's see. Han Dynasty. Han Dynasty. No, don't see it here. Okay, Han Dynasty. Han Dynasty.
Han Dynasty. I don't see it here. It's not on this page.
No.
Han Dynasty.
No, don't see it here.
Han.
I've searched for an hour.
Han Dynasty.
I can't find it here.
Han Dynasty. Where are you?
Han Dynasty.
I'm looking all over for you. Han Dynasty. I found nothing in this. Hey, you know what? There is no significance to it.
What made Judaism and Christianity so significant is that they were strongly monotheistic during their time, besides Zoroastrianism, but they are a copycat of Judaism. They had similar history, beliefs, commandments, and prophecies, which makes the Bible dance in such poetry from one author to the next and vast generations in between. The book as a whole is so clear in its consistency, which we could only surmise that each author were inspired by the same spirit. So when it comes to the Han Dynasty, Han Mother explains how they worship heaven and how beautiful their kingdom was. But do they really worship heaven? Maybe. But their religious and philosophical background is different. Their philosophical background was Confucius mixed with Taoism, and then they eventually adopted Buddhism. Yes, the Divine Principle has mentioned these philosophies and religions being raised up by God, but they are peripheral to providence. They don't carry the seed where Christ can come. These religions were meant to accept Jesus and to be engrafted by Christ or the true olive tree. And so is their future for the second coming. And sure, these religions and philosophies are good, but only to a certain extent. Let's take a look at what they produce as a society. Confucianism, though it has strong beliefs and family values, yet it has a system that teaches their people to submit and pledge loyalty to their government. Taoism and Buddhism, though, helps enhance people's individual lives, but in the end, they get tempted into self-worship, becoming gods themselves, mainly because in their teachings, there isn't a personal god. So they have nowhere else to turn to but worship themselves. Within Judeo-Christianity is the only culture that produced the most freedom. Besides centralized Christianity, it recognized a fundamental core, and that is a personal relationship with God. Through that on the foundation of the Bible, we recognize an inherent value in each individual through the eyes of our Creator. And on that basis, we have a bottom-up system, a culture that a man is not ruled by another man, nor another God, but is ruled by their conscience. And in those cultures exude life and creativity and prosperity for everyone.
That is sexist!
I don't want to hear it!
So what is Han Mother's kind of culture that she wants to produce from her Confucius, Taoist, Buddhist background? Well, I can make sense of that later.
Hey, thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. If you don't like it, well, do whatever you want. The next video in the making is called Does DP Support Socialism? It's a two-part series, one covering the economics of Chonggak, and second part is the politics within it. I put in a lot of study to it, and I know people get allergic or get confused by DP, but I try to make it easy and enjoyable to learn. I hope that people will understand better of the reality of the kingdom will be based on the DP, rather than being some ethereal idea. Alright, hope to see you again. Peace!